Yo, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to another Madden 20 online CFM game. We are now in week 14 of the 2023 season here in the Premier Madden League, and we have some Thursday night football on deck between the New England Patriots and the Miami Dolphins. As these two AFC East rivals meet for the second time this season, the division crown will not be on the line. Because with our Dolphins pulling out yet another comeback victory last week against the Bills, coupled with a New England Patriots loss in week 13, that means our Miami Dolphins have officially clinched the AFC East division with 4 games left in the regular season. So all we really have to focus on now with our Phins is securing a first round bye, which as we check the standings is looking like a pretty good possibility. We have a 2-game lead on the Colts and a 3-game lead on both the Ravens and the Broncos. Keep in mind, we have played all of these top teams and beaten them all except the Kansas City Chiefs. So we have tiebreakers over a lot of these squads. So that 2-game lead on the Colts is really a 3-game lead. So really, in essence, all we have to do is not completely fall apart and lose our last 4 games of the season, and we will have ourselves a first round bye. So that means we could take somewhat of a casual approach to these last couple of weeks. Now, the New England Patriots do not have that same luxury. Even though they have a 6-6 record, they are very much in play for a wild card position in the AFC conference. Pretty much, the Patriots need to win out to try to get themselves a wild card berth, and defeating our Dolphins will not be an easy task, but the Patriots are still alive, and they'll be playing with their butts on fire as their season is on the line tonight. Our Miami Dolphins welcome back Jabril Cox and Saquon Barkley, two big superstar names on each side of the football. Of course, Saquon Barkley has had quite the injury-riddled season, so we haven't really seen much of Saquon so far. We haven't seen him since week 5 against those Denver Broncos. Here we are, and we are underway. The 6-6 New England Patriots on the road to take on the 11-1 number one seed in the AFC Conference, Miami Dolphins. Sam Darnold downfield right away, and he's got Philip Dorsett. Into the end zone, 10 seconds into the action, and the Patriots are on top early. The PAT up and good, forgot to show that one, but what a play by the Patriots to start things off. You want to talk about making a statement. Darnold in the tightest of windows over the safety, Adrian Colbert, finds Dorsett for the touchdown. Here's Barkley back in the action. Barkley hoping to really just not get injured today. Jakeem Grant knocked around. That's incomplete. Of course, Jameson Crowder is out for the rest of the regular season, so you'll see a lot of Jakeem Grant. Third down, Watson, a lot of time, but not able to locate anyone, and down he goes. Klein gets the sack, but that's really a coverage sack right there by the New England Patriots defense, forcing the early three and out. Coupled with the early touchdown, safe to say, momentum on New England's side, but there's a lot of time. We're only a minute and a half left in the game. These are 10-minute quarters, and most importantly, our Miami Dolphins are the comeback kids, as Sony Michel trying to get wiggly, trying to get sticky, but he might have lost a yard on that one. So it's third down and 14 for Sam Darnold. 3-man rush, but here comes the big brown truck inside. Derrick Brown is an unstoppable force in the trenches. He proves it yet again. He has the most sacks this season for a very stacked Miami Dolphins front seven, as Saquon Barkley. Yeah, we definitely miss having that. We haven't been running the ball too much these days, you know, mainly because we keep on having running backs getting hurt. But with Saquon Barkley in here, we're going to try to limit Saquon's snaps this week. But, you know, we still got to get him fresh, feel him out a little bit. As second down, it's a fake. It's going to go to Kalen Ballage. Ballage mishandling the ball and goes the wrong way. Dean able to make the tackle. It's actually going to be a loss of a couple of yards as the Patriots bring the blitz inside the little engine that could Jakeem Grant. I know Jameson Crowder. Oh, no. I was just about to talk about Jameson Crowder's injury. Saquon Barkley is hurt again as Deshaun Watson up the middle. Watson gets the first down, but we are on pins and needles waiting to hear what happened to Saquon Barkley, who didn't even last the first quarter, as Watson is popped. That's incomplete, and it's a dislocated shoulder for Saquon Barkley. He's definitely out for the game, and who knows how much longer. You gotta be kidding me. He did not even make it through the first quarter. Third down, Watson trying to calm things down after our Dolphins are very upset about what happened, but we just got to move on. We've been playing the whole season without Saquon Barkley, so what's one more game, I suppose? But, you know, the main thing is just how many more games besides this one do we have without Barkley? Is he out for the season? And I decided, you know what, let me pause and see, you know, what's going on with this dislocated shoulder. It says out for the game, so that might actually be a good thing. Now, dislocated shoulders, you know, it kind of depends on the severity of the shoulder. You know, it's a separated shoulder. I think it's a lot worse, but you know, if it says out for the game there, he might just legitimately be out for this game only. So that might be a good thing for our Miami Dolphins. Give Saquon another week off. Why not? Let's, for now, focus on this third down, trying to stop Sam Darnold, Sony Michel, and this Patriots offense. Man in motion, Darnold time. And no, oh man, all the time in the world, but nothing open. Coverage stout. Xavier Howard breaking the ball up, and the Patriots punt the ball right back. Besides that, early downfield bomb has been quite the defensive battle early in the going. Look at Dotson reversing fields. Oh my goodness, Dotson is a threat to take any return back for a touchdown. Grant is a threat to take any sweep back for a touchdown, though that time he only gets 2 yards. Second down, Watson middle, and that's gonna be incomplete, looking for Paulson. Third down and 8, last play of the first quarter. Once again, a three-man rush for this Patriots defense. Watson out of control, and down he goes once again. This Miami offense is looking shaky, to say the least, to start things off. A couple of possessions and we have barely been able to get first down so far, which is kind of a far cry to what we've been playing the last couple of weeks against the Buffalo Bills. And whoa, what a great pass from Sam Darnold, and also the Baltimore Ravens, where especially DeAndre Hopkins was going off. This is more shades of the way we played against the New York Jets a couple of weeks ago, where we struggled a bit offensively and it was just a grinded out defensive battle. We have one of those on our hands today, it looks like, unless somebody's offense wakes up. Third down, maybe it's the Patriots. Kneel Harry, I believe his name is, or N'Keal Harry, whichever way you pronounce that one. I apologize for probably getting it wrong there with both of those attempts. As Darnold, that pass attempt's not getting off. It's Derrick Brown again, his second sack of the first half. The blitz on 3rd and 20, and the Patriots pick it up, giving Darnold time, but it's going to be hard to get 20 yards on one play against this Miami secondary. Caden Stearns makes the tackle. The Patriots not in field goal range, and unfortunately for them, they can't pin the Dolphins too deep in their own territory. That punt goes for a touchback. It's a play action shot play on first down. That is not really working out until Watson goes across the field and finds Jakeem Grant, who's been pretty busy early on in this one. So now that Saquon Barkley's hurt once again, it's going to be up to Kalen Ballage, Corey Grant, and Kalen Ballage to do their, or Kenyon Drake to do their thing. As second down, whoa, what a weird looking play. I accidentally hit the wrong button there after I shook off the sack. I meant to throw it to Grant, who was wide open, but once again, I think an X and triangle got me all mixed up. That time, there was no time. Chase Winovich, that was a quick pass rush, beating the double team. Watson down, then we punt the ball yet again. There were really too many options on third down, especially the way we are playing offensively. These are one of these games where, you know, we really have to rely on our defense to keep us in it, and, you know, since the opening play, we've been pretty disciplined on this end of the football. Second down, trying to send the blitz. Sony Michel gonna get quite the block from Ian Thomas, taking away two Dolphins and getting the Patriots to midfield out of the 2 minute warning. Sony Michel not getting anything going in the ground game. Second down, still nothing for Michel. Darnold's been pretty productive, but the Patriots are still trying to maintain the balance of rushing and passing. Third down, you gotta expect Darnold to get the ball, which he does. Play action once again, the three man rush. This time Darnold's got time, has space, but not enough to get the first down. And once again, at the same spot where the previous drive ended, the 45-yard line. It's not field goal range. It's not a position you want to punt the ball. And the Patriots, unfortunately for them, have to punt. But this is a better punt this time around, where, you know, we're backed up at our own 10-yard line with a minute to go. The way our offense is looking, it's going to be hard for us to produce anything. We just got to play smart and not dig ourselves a bigger hole than we are already into in this game with a second half to play. As Kenyon Drake gets the handoff after the hurry up, Drake does get the first down, but, you know, we're still at our own 22-yard line. We're not calling a timeout. We're not going to force the issue here, but we are going to get a snap off, see what we could do. Look to take a shot downfield, looking for Hopkins, but Watson rolls the pocket, throws the ball away. Once again, not trying to, you know, make more mistakes than we already have in this game. As Jakeem Grant on the jet sweep, let's just let Jakeem Grant do something with the ball in his hands. He does get the first down. We're going to call a timeout out here. Maybe we could get into field goal range. Maybe more than that. Looking for Hopkins, who has been silenced so far. J.C. Jackson gets the interception, and the final play of the first half is still alive until Paulson, the tight end, makes the tackle, and the score is 7-3. The Patriots still sitting on that big opening play to Dorsett as our Miami Dolphins look to take over at the start of the second half. And with the way the Patriots have dominated this game, if we could put together a touchdown drive here, you have to believe that would be demoralizing for a team that is fighting for their lives to try to, you know, keep their playoff hopes alive. The way they've been playing in this first half, the last thing they want to do is see themselves down by 3 points at the end of this drive. New set of downs after the catch by D-Hop. Watson rolling away again. And this coverage defense by the Patriots, you know, it's been consistent. Three with a quarterback spy every single time. Oh, look at Winovich inside. Immediate pressure. Klein for the touchdown. Wow. Winovich again just immediately beating a double team. And Watson did not stand the chance. Loses the ball. Watson's fumbling has become a bit of an issue the past couple of weeks. Remember last week against the Buffalo Bills, almost cost us the game there. I believe this is the third game in a row where Watson has lost a fumble, and all three of those lost fumbles have resulted in touchdowns. And a game like this, the last thing you want to do is give up a defensive touchdown on a play like that. We're looking to grab the momentum out of halftime. Instead, we've just handed the Patriots all the confidence in the world. Looking to go downfield for Godwin. That's not going to work. The downfield passing attack just has not been there all game long. It's going to have to be a lot of underneath throws if we're going to get ourselves back into this game. You know, maybe some rushing plays, but we haven't been running the ball too much since Barkley went out, as that is Godwin making the spectacular grab over the linebacker, Jake Ryan. There's a rush on first down, but Kenyon Drake not getting too much so far. Once again, this is Chris Godwin actually on the sweep. Godwin getting a nice juke move, fighting for whatever yardage he can. Gets to the 36-yard line, third down and four, five wide for Watson. Yet again, the three-man rush with the quarterback spy, and one of the linemen drops back and nearly gets the interception. The field goal unit out on the field. Yet again, windy conditions, but we are able to knock it up and good with Joey Sly, and we do make it a one-possession game. Now, as long as we can limit some of these big plays the Patriots have been getting, because that's kind of been their bread and butter, you know, one defensive touchdown, one-play touchdown. Otherwise, you know, we are definitely very well still in this game, as downfield, there's a big one. That's exactly what we were talking about not giving up, as Darnold continues his low-key, very good game. As the Patriots continue to run the ball with no success, Darnold, whether it's passing or taking off with the football, is having a phenomenal game. Third down, though, they're really going to need a first down play from Darnold, who has the time. And he has Harry in the middle. He's open. He's got it. And now a goal-to-go opportunity for the Patriots, who would love to get a touchdown and really put the Dolphins on their back heels, as Michelle back-to-back carries, not getting too much. 14 rushes, 16 yards. It's been absolutely stuffing all day by this Miami defense. The Patriots are going to try it again, and why not? This time it finally works out, and Michelle on third down and six from the goal line gets the touchdown. And that's not a bad play call right there, because third down and six at the goal line there, hard to pass the ball. Might as well just run it one more time, see what happens. You know, I always like to say it is Madden 20, so, you know, you got a decent chance in there. You know, the Patriots actually flipped the formation, playing a lot of little chess games in there, and are able to get the touchdown. So, you know, once again, the Patriots, they're playing with the urgency they need to be playing with their season on the line. Our Miami Dolphins, especially on the offensive end, not so much, as we continue to probably look for too many shot plays, and we got to calm things down just a little bit. The second design quarterback run for Deshaun Watson, the first one got a first down after Barkley got hurt. That time, not too much. Third down and nine. This is not going to work out. That was nearly J.C. Jackson's second interception, and to start the fourth quarter, yeah, it's desperation time. We're going to go for it here from our own 31-yard line. Watson rolling the pocket, but he stays behind the line so we could try to pass the football. Watson is now out of time. Deshaun Watson indecisive yet again. Wilson gets the credit for the sack right there, and it's going to be a turnover on downs regardless. That could be the final dagger, but then again, you got to keep in mind these are the Miami Dolphins. Third down and four. Patriots keep it on the ground, and for the time being, this Dolphins defense continues to lock down the rushing attack, and the field goal up and good. That does make it a three possession game, so that's great news for the Patriots. 18-point lead. Our Dolphins are going to need a whole lot to get back into this game, but These are the comeback kids after all. Have we dug ourselves too deep of a deficit? Oh, maybe we got that kick return. Maybe not. But Dawson is just brought down as Watson rolling, buying all the time. He possibly can. Oh, Kenyon Drake takes a monster hit inside. But he's able to hang on for the first down. No huddle by a Dolphins attack that knows time is against them. Watson popped. Just gets it off. Kenyon Drake makes the catch. The Patriots continue to consistently rush three with a quarterback's bye every single time, and that kind of coverage defense mentality seems to be bottling up this Miami attack, as a rare Patriots blitz right there is able to actually get us a decent gain to Dawson. But yeah, this Patriots defensive mentality has kind of been stymizing a Dolphins attack that's probably looking for the shot play one too many times, as Watson just gets it off for the incompletion as he takes the hit. Third down and three. We just got to score a touchdown at some point, right? And then let the cards fall whatever way they fall. Probably go for an onside kick afterwards. But first things first, we got to try to score this touchdown. Watson moving, throwing. Kenyon Drake's been pretty busy on this drive. He makes the catch, gets the first down to the 13-yard line. D-hop. Oh, Hopkins popped. And that's going to be an interception for Cam Brown, the inside linebacker Patriots at their own 1 yard line. Definitely want to make sure they don't give up a safety here as they continue to go conservative with the lead, just giving Michelle carry after carry. He continues to get nothing after nothing. So third down, Sam Darnold's going to try to get this first down himself. Gets it off. And what poise by Darnold from his own end zone, finding the rookie Daniel George for the first down. Dorsett! You do not want to fumble the ball with the lead. The Patriots looking pretty good now after that one first down, and yeah, basically in position to chew up clock. And as we call a timeout, this is actually a first down by the Patriots. I called a timeout thinking that it was going to be third down and inches and we could try to get the ball back, but it's a new set of downs for the Patriots. And yeah, it's pretty much going to be, if the Patriots don't throw a pick six or do something crazy, it's going to be a maybe a bit too tough of a comeback for our Dolphins, who once again, you know, I'd say this is very similar to the Jets game where, you know, offensively we just did not bring it. And defensively, I would say we did a pretty good job in this one, especially in the rushing attack. Sony Michel has been getting nothing all game long. We might have actually knocked the Patriots out of field goal range here on third down. Fullback dive, yeah, that's definitely not going to be field goal range, as James White in the fullback position, he gets nothing. And you know, the amount of times we've held the Patriots outside of field goal range, you know, at the 43 or 45 yard line, we've done a lot right defensively, it's just a lot wrong offensively. So we're gonna have to go back into the lab a little bit and work on playing a little bit smarter offensively, probably, you know, get a bit more rushes in. We didn't run the ball nearly enough in this game, especially for the way the Patriots were playing coverage defense. So you know, in essence, I would say this is kind of a game our Dolphins need it, because the last couple of weeks we've really been flirting with the edge of aggressiveness offensively, right? You know, when you think about the Jets game, you think about the Bills game that we, you know, almost lost about 10 different times. Now, it worked out well for us in the Baltimore game, but, you know, that kind of attack's not going to work out against every single defense, against every single play style. So, you know, yeah, as this is going to be the final play, DeAndre Hopkins does not make the catch. Our Miami Dolphins officially suffer our first loss since opening night against the New York Giants. The New England Patriots keep their season alive with a big victory on the road on primetime television against our Miami Dolphins. But yeah, you know, I feel like, you know, in a CFM, sometimes you need a game like this, like a reality check, you know? If we just went through the rest of the regular season and just continued to win games we were not supposed to win, we would have never learned our lesson. The amount of times that we have come close to losing a game this season and have not lost them has been insurmountable. Like, week 4 against the Raiders, week 5 against the Broncos, week 2 against the Jets, last week against the Bills. There's been so many of those games that we can recall. So to actually lose one of these games is probably a good thing for our Miami Dolphins, because like I said, it's going to take a monumental sell for us to not get a first round bye and probably the number one seed in the AFC conference. But you know, a loss like this is not going to help us. It's going to have to make us lock in a little bit for next week's game against the Kansas City Chiefs. Yet again, the schedule does not get easier for our Dolphins this season. Thankfully, Saquon Barkley not hurt for next week, so the dislocated shoulder was only for last week's game, so that's a big sigh of relief. So that's going to do it for this week's video. Leave a like on the video if you guys enjoyed what you guys saw today. Subscribe for more Madden 20 gameplays, especially if you guys want to keep up with this Dolphins CFM. I will catch you guys next time, where hopefully we can redeem ourselves and play less sloppy.